नियतिकृतनियमरहितां श्लाघैकमयीं अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिं दधति भारती कवेर्जयति. यू केन् म्यूट् युवर् सेल्फ् एण्ड् देन् इफ् यु हेव् अ डौट् यु केन् अन्म्यूट्. ओके,
Yes, ma'am.
so we'll start now. We have to start with lupta upama. The definition of just upama alankara we saw last week. It was a sadharmyam upama bhede, where you'll have to have upamanam, upameya, and then there is a sadharana dharmam or sadharmyam, along with upama vachaka shabdaha or upama dyotaka shabdaha. Now we look at lupta upama. Any of these four, if one or two or three of these four items are missing, then it is called lupta upama. Lupta means missing. Tadvat dharmasya lope syat na shrauti taddhite punaha. Dharmaha sadharanaha taddhite kalpapadau tu arthi eva tena pancha. So dharma lupta. So you have upamana, upameya, sadharana dharma, and then upama dyotaka shabda. First he deals with dharma lupta, next he will deal with upamana lupta, then upama dyotaka lupta, then upameya lupta. Dharma lupta means the commonality between two objects. He just says chandraiva mukham. That's all he says. He doesn't say chandraiva mukham akarshakaraha asti or akarshakaram asti. That akarshakaram atava kanti yuktam, these common dharma is not mentioned at all. So for that, again, that dharma lukta is also divided into shrauti and arthi. In shrauti, you don't have taddhitam. The rest are all present. Shrauti is again divided into vakyaga and samasaga. Arthi, you have vakyaga, samasaga and taddhitaka. So tadvat dharmasya lope, when the dharma is absent, syat na shrauti taddhite. In shrauti, you don't have the only the taddhita, the rest are all present. So there are five types of dharma lopaha. Dharmaha sadharanaha taddhite kalpap adau tu arthi eva. Kalpap is a type of pratyayam where you say chandrakalpaha. Chandrakalpaha means chandra eva bhasate. That eva is used as in a pratyayam called kalpap. When that happens, it is an arthi upama. So dharma luptayaha panchavedaha udaharanam. He starts off with the first vakyaga dharma lupta, and then he gives for samasaga and then taddhitaka. So vakyaga dharma lupta, but the first one is shrauti, the next one is arthi. If you remember, shrauti means it is like a sentence where he uses yatha tatha or eva, and there is a sixth case associated with it, whereas tena tulyaha, tena satrashaha, tena samanaha, if we have the samaha, if we have the third vibhakti in it, then it is arthi upama. So dhanyasya ananya samanya saujanya utkarsha shalinaha karaniyam vachaha chetaha satyam tasya amritam yatha. So dhanyasya ananya samanya saujanya utkarsha shalinaha karaniyam vachaha chetaha satyam tasya amritam yatha. For the anvayam, I just wanted to, 1 minute, show the text. Where is the text? Yes?
Ma'am, it is Tasya Amritam Vachaha or Tada? Here we have Vachaha.
No, no. Vachaha Chetaha Satyam Tasya Amritam Yatha. What is given in your text?
Karaniyam Vachastena Satyam Tasya Amritam Vachaha.
Oh, karaniyam vachastena satyamritam. And then there is no upama vachaka shabdam there.
Okay.
Tatha yatha in nothing is there. Note down what you said. What did you say? It is karaniyam vachastena.
Vachastena. Satyam tasya amritam vachaha.
Satyam
tena is there, na? Tritiya.
No, then it will become arthi. No, no, that is not wrong. Tena. Satyam vachas tena satyam tasya amritam Vachaha. No, change it easily. It is wrong.
Okay.
Okay, you can just look at this text and write it down like that. Okay,
Yatha.
karaniyam chetaha satyam tasyamritam yatha. You need yatha. It is only dharma lopa. It is an example for sadharana dharma lopa, which means you have upamanam, upameyam, and upama vachaka shabda. In that reading, there is no upama vachaka shabda. So, he chetaha amritam tasya vachaha. Tasya vachaha, his words are like amritam. The adjective for him are dhanyasya, ananya, samanya, saujanya, utkarsha, shalinaha. The person whose words are like amritam satyam karaniyam. And it is true that we have to follow the words that that sadhu has said. Because he is dhanyaha, he is a very fortunate person. He is also samanya saujanya utkarsha shalinaha, utkarsha shali. He has a very saujanyam, very nice quality in him, which is utkarsham. Adhikyena shalate iti adhikyena shobhate tasmin samanya saujanyam. He has a very ananya samanya saujanyam. He has a saujanyam which is not commonly found in him. I think you should mute yourself. Saujanyam or sulabhata, very easy to connect with him. That sujanatvam, a good person, right? That good quality that is there in that person is praising. He is praising someone and saying, "Hey Chetaha, mind, you will have to follow the words of that person whose words are like amritam." That is the meaning of the shlokam. Because he is a very fortunate person. Dhanyaha saha, sadhuhu saha, ananya samanya saujanya, tasminna saujanyam asti, sujamata asti, yat ananya sadharana. Which is very difficult to find in another person. Tena utkarsha shali, he has it in abundance in him. Tadrishasya sadhoho vachaha, amritam yatha amritam, tatha satyam karaniyam. So you have to follow. Just like how amritam is very good for us. It gives us happiness in the same way. His words are also giving us happiness. So here, upamanam is amritam. Upameyam that we are describing is vachaha. Upama pratipadaka shabdaha is yata that we have. Sadharana dharmam is just like how amritam also gives us happiness. In the same way, his words are happiness, not only happiness, it's also hitakaratvam, hitakari. Amritam, removes the, amritam makes us immortal, or it gives us good, it is beneficial to us. The same way, his words are also going to be only beneficial to us and gives us happiness. So that the sadharana dharmam is missing here. We understand it from the word. That's why it is dharma lukta. Shrauti upama, because you have tasya amritam amritasya santosha janakatvam yatha vartate tata tasya vachasaha api santosha janakatvam vartate iti sambandha shashti natra vartate. When that is how we understand the similarity between amritam and vachaha. Hence it is shrauti upama and it is vakyaga. It is not in a samasam. Next is vakyaga dharmalupta arthi. आकृष्ट करवालः असौ संपराये परिभ्रमन् प्रत्यर्थि सेनया दृष्टः कृतांतेन समः प्रभुः. Directly the word that we need is कृतांतेन समः प्रभुः. That gives you the upama beautifully. So how is the Prabhu? Description of a king is here. आकृष्ट करवालः असौ. He has his sword drawn out for fighting. संपराये परिभ्रमन्. He roams around in the संपराये battlefield. Pratyarthi senaya drishtaha. He was seen by the enemy army. Pratyarthi shatru. Shatru senaya drishtaha saha prabhu nripaha kritantena samaha. He is equal to yama. Yamena samaha drishtaha. He was seen equal to yama. Now, very simple one where upamanam is kritantaha yama. And the moment we say the word yama, you think of death, you think of kruratvam, maranadayakaha, all of these comes to our mind. So we don't even need to tell the dharmam in this. So without the dharmam, it is more attractive actually. Luptopama is somewhat, I think it is more beautiful than Purnopama in some cases. Because it is left to the imagination of the Sahrudaya. You leave more in the form of imagination than you expressing it everything in the shlokam itself. So here Kritantaha is your Upamanam, Upameyam is Prabhu or Nripaha. The samaha equal, kritantena samaha, he is equal to yama. That samaha is the shabdam which is upama pratipadakaha. Sadharmyam, you can say kruratvam, marana, hetuhu, he is the karana, marana karanam asti saha, shatru, bhayankaraha, anything you can have as the sadharana dharma which is not mentioned in the shloka. Okay. Now again that tena tulyaha has come, hence it is arthi upama. Next one is samasaga and taddhitaga, dharmalupta, shrauti, arti, all of that is mentioned in this one shloka itself. So karavala ivacharaha tasya vag amrutopama vishakalpam manovetsi yadi jivasi tat sakhe. Sakhe, very interesting this thing, the see. हे सखे तस्य प्रकृतस्य दुष्टस्य आचारः आचारणम् आचरणम् हे सखे दिस इज समवन हु इज ट्राइंग टू गिव एन एडवाइस टू अनदर पर्सन सेइंग यू नो दैट पर्सन इज वेरी बैड पर्सन सः दुष्टः अस्ति तस्य आचारः करवालैव अस्ति वेन एवर ही परफॉर्म्स एनीथिंग इट इज लाइक अ स्वॉर्ड लाइक समवन इज हिटिंग यू विद अ स्वॉर्ड किलिंग यू विद अ स्वॉर्ड वाक् अमृत उपमा हिज वर्ड्स But his words are like nectar. He speaks very sweet words, but his actions are like sword. Vishakalpam manaha. His mind is like poison. So one whose mind is filled with poison, but his words are all amritam, nectar, and his actions are like sword. How can you believe this person? Right? Yadi jivasi, yadi vetsi, tat jivasi. If you understand everything about him like this, then you can survive. If you don't understand, then it is very difficult to survive with the association of this person. Very tough, right? So karavalaiva acharaha, sword. His actions are like a sword. Kripanaha iva tasya chesta. That is, it's tadrisha kruratvam athava ghatukatvam asti. He can easily kill people with his actions. Vaku amritam, very attractive. You easily get attracted to whatever he is saying and you believe him because of the words he is saying. Vishakalpam manaha. Whereas his mind, he has something else in his mind, which is like visham. Maybe visham, you know, is very sweet to drink and then suddenly it will kill you. So you don't know how its effect will be. You will know the effect only later. So that is the manaha. You don't know what is in his mind, but understand that his mind is vishakalpam. It is like visham, right? Yadi vetsi, yadi janasi, if you know all of these things, tarahi jivasi, then only you can survive. Otherwise, you cannot survive in the company of this person. Samasaga. So the first one, let's look at the karavalaivacharaha is a samasa. Here, it is a samasta padam where you have upamanam, which is karavala. Eva is the upama pratipadaka shabdaha. Acharaha is the upameyam. His action is like that of a sword. Karavalasya acharaha eva acharaha asya vartate. So how is that connection there? Karavalasya eva. The shashti vibhakti is coming there. That is why it is shrauti upama. You don't have, what is the common dharmam between a sword and his action, which is ghatakatvam, it is capable of killing. That is the sadharana dharmam. That sadharana dharmam is not present here. You have the rest in this. And that karavala ivacharaha is one samasta padam, it is a compound word, it is a samasa. Hence, samasaga dharmalukta shrauti. Next is samasaga dharmalupta arthi upama. Vak amrita upama. Tasya vak amritam iva amritena upamiyate. Amrita upama. वाक् अमृतेन उपमीयते इति वाक् अमृतोपमा. सो वा अमृतेन उपमीयते, यु हाव् द तृतीय विभक्ति देर्, सो इट् इस् अर्थी उपमा. धर्मलुप्ता बिकास् यु डोण्ट् हाव् दट् माधुर्यं. वाक् माधुर्यं, वाचि यत् माधुर्यम्, अमृते यत् माधुर्यम् अस्ति तादृशमाधुर्यम् अस्य वाचि अपि वर्तते इति साधर्म्यस्य तत्र लोपः. साधर्म्यं तु न उपात्तम्, सो इट् इस् धर्मलुप्ता. अण्ड् अर्थि ऐ टोल्ड् यु इट् इस् बिकास् आफ् दट् तेन. अण्ड् वाग् अमृतोपमा इस् आल्सो ए समस्तपदम्, और् वाक् अमृतोपमा इस् अ समस्तपदं हियर्. ओके, ऐ थिङ्क् करवाल इव इस् युर् समस्तपदम्, अण्ड् देन् करवाल इव आचारः इस् युर् उपमेयम्. ओके, नेक्स्ट् इस् विषकल्पम्. ऐ टोल्ड् यु कल्पप् इस् अ प्रत्ययम् विच् इस् यूस्ड् ईषदर्थे, ईषत् सादृश्यार्थे. अण्ड् उपमानम् इस् विषम् poison, upameyam is manaha, vishakalpam manaha is upama pratipadakam is your vishakalpam. Kalpam is the kalpap. Ishat asamaptav, ishat little bit, but it is not purnam, visha purnam nasti, kintu tatra ishat visha sadrisham asti. Just his mere mind, if he thinks something, he is not a great sadhu, that the moment he thinks badly about someone, that person is going to die. So it is not sampurnena vishakalpameva natu visha eva he is not totally like poison. If he was totally like poison, that means there should be death there. His mind should be able to cause death to another person. That's why he is saying ishatu visha eva asti. So he is saying ishata asamaptau kalpap deshya deshiya. You can also say visha deshiyaha athava visha deshyam manaha, vishadeshiyam manaha, that is also means ishat sadrishyam. So kalpap is the pratyayam, so you have the upama pratipadaka shabda is also there, which is a taddita pratyayam. The nashakatvam or to destroy a person's life, that's all, not to kill another person, that is there in karavalam. That is a direct action is present there. But mind, you can destroy a person by talking bad things and thinking about how to, you can plan bad things about another person, right? So that is manas. Sadharmyam is not given. So this is a taddhitaga dharmalukta arthi. Next we go to upamana lukta. Upamana anupadane, upamana anupadane, when upamanam is not taken, dharmam is there, upamadyotakam is there, upameyam is there. All three are present, only the upamana is absent. Vakyaga atha samasaga, there are only two types that can happen. If the upamanam is absent, you can only have arthi upama, because you can't have tasya eva mukhasya, sorry, chandrasya eva, the chandra has to be present, otherwise there is no anvayam can happen, the anvaya cannot happen there. Why we don't have taddhitaga is because taddhitaga is not at all present there. First, shrauti is not present. Shrauti is not present because eva, etc., have to have the upamana for it to have an anvaya. Upamana is saha eva anvitaha ivadi shabdaha. So you cannot have shrauti upama at all. You can only have arthi upama. In arthi upama also taddhitaga, taddhita pratyayam cannot be included, because taddhita pratyayam is always used only after the upamana padam. Without the upamana padam present, you cannot have a taddhita pratyaya. Hence there is no taddhitaga. You have only vakyaga and samasaga, that too only arthi upama. He gives two examples for that. So the first one is sakala karana पर विश्राम श्री वितरणं न सरसकाव्यस्य दृश्यते अथवा निशम्यते सदृशम् अंशांशमात्रेण. देर् इस् एक्चुअली ओन्ली वन् श्लोकं गिवेन् फार् दिस्, एण्ड् इफ् यु लुक् इट् द टेक्स्ट्, द श्लोकं दट् इस् गिवेन् इस् इन् प्राकृतम्, एण्ड् अण्डर्नीत् इन् दट् ही सेस् काव्यस्य इत्यत्र काव्यसमम् इति, सरसम् सरिसम् इत्यत्र नूनम् इति पाठे एषा एव समासका. सो द सेम् श्लोकम् विद् टु पाठभेदम् he is giving examples for both samasaga vakyaga arthi, upamana lupta arthi, and samasaga upamana lupta arthi. So I've just given both the same number. That's why it's the same shlokam with a different patabedam. Then you will have different luptopama. Sakala karana para vishrama shri vitaranam na drishyate athava na nishamyate sarasa kavyasya amshamsha matrena sadrasham. When you read a kavyam which is sarasam, which has so much of essence, so much of beauty in it, any rasapur purna kavyam yeda pathyate tat sadrisham kimapi nasti na drishyate athava na nishamyate na shruyate. We can't even see another kavyam like that. Amshamsha matrena, amsham is one portion, and a portion of that portion is amshamsha matrena sadrisham, something which is equal to amsha amsha. A portion of its portion itself we cannot see, or we cannot hear about another kavyam. So a kavyam is so much more beautiful. Saka, how is it beautiful? What is the dharmam that is given here? So sarasa kavyam is your upameya. Sarasa kavyena sadrisham amshamsha matrena sadrisham. Sadrisham is your upama pratipadaka shabda that is given. The dharmam, the quality is sakala karana para vishrama shri vitaranam. Sakala karanam, karanam is all your indriya. Every indriya para vishrama, it attains a great solace in this beauty. It gives out such a beauty. Shri vitaranam karoti etat sarasa kavyam. Sarasa kavyasya shrihi, the beauty of that kavyam is such that all our indriyas attain one peaceful state when we read such a beautiful kavya. So sakala karana paravishrama shri vitaranam yatha syat tatha na drishyate kutrapi. So there is no upamanam here, upamana bahyam. Nagendra hastaha vachi karkashatvat. When describing Parvati, he says upamana bahyaha, it's her thighs are beyond any upamanam. You cannot find an upamanam for her thighs. So it is like an upamana lopam. The Nagendra hastaha tvachi karkashatvat. If you want to compare it to the trunk of an elephant, if the elephant's trunk is very rough, but her thighs are not like that. Parvati's thighs are not like that, right? So tvachi karkashatvat ekanta shaityat kadali visheshat. No, it's like, you know, banana tree, the stalk of a banana tree. Ekanta shaityam, if you touch the banana tree's stalk, that vaadathandu, ekanta shaityam, it is always cold. It's always cool to touch, whether the weather is cold or whether, if the weather is hot also, that it will be cold. Whereas the thighs, it's during cold weather, it's supposed to be very warm. For touch, and during warm weather it is supposed to be cool for touch. So it depends on the, it's a body temperature that is reflected, right? So ekanta shaityate kadali visheshaha, it's difficult to compare it to the kadali vishesham also, nor is it possible to compare Parvati's thighs to the Nagendra hastaha. Upamana, upamana vahyaha, difficult to find another upamanam for her thaisa. Luptopamak, best example. Don't take that as an example and write it, please. But I'm telling you to understand what is upamana bhakyam. It's very similar to that. Sarasa kavyasya amshamsha matrena sadrisham sakala karana para vishrama shri vitaranam na drishyate athava na nishamyate. We can't even hear of such a kavya. You got the idea. Now changing it to he is using, now we'll have to say samasaka, right? So using that samam, the upama vachaka shabda, he puts it in the samasam and makes a patavedam by sakala karana para vishrama shri vitaranam na sarasa kavya samam. Sarasa kavyena samam kimapi nasti. So sarasa kavyena samam, kavya samam is a samastapadam, which is also a upama pratipadaka shabda. Sarasa kavyam again is your upameyam. Sadharana dharmam is again the sakala karana para vishrama shri. And instead of using that sadrisham, he uses noonam padam, where he says, indeed, you cannot hear. nor can you see such a kavya. This is samasaga upamanalukta arthi. Next is upamadyotakalukta. The he is giving a lot of examples for this. There are about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 examples, I think, for this. So vader lope samasesa karmadhara kyachi kyangi karma kartroho namuli. This is first the karika that you see here. Vader lope samasesa karmadharaya kyachi kyangi karma kartroho namuli. And then there is your vritti. Va shabdaha upama dyotakaha. Now we are looking at upama dyotaka lopam. Right? So upama dyotaka lopam, you can have samasaga. Upama pratipadakasya lope. Vadi shabdaha upama dyotakaha iti vadehe. Upama pratipadakasya lope. Shat samasena. कर्मणः अधिकरणात् च उत्पन्नेन क्यच कर्तुः क्यङ कर्मकर्त्रोः उपपदयोः नमुला च भवति. सो इवादि शब्द यु केनाट् हाव् श्रौति वाक्यगा एण्ड् तद्धितगा. यु केन् हाव् ओन्लि समासगा एण्ड् देन् द रेस्ट् आर् आल् आर्थि बिकास् यु काण्ट् हाव् वाक्यगा एण्ड् तद्धितगा. If there is no Iva Shabdam at all, then it is difficult to have that. In Samasam, you can have the Iva as a Lopam, where, you know, Upama Vachaka Shabda can be within the, it is Luptam inside a Samasam. Then it is possible. That way, that Shashti Vibhakti is also there and the Shruti Upama can also be possible. The rest are all Arthi Upama. So Samasaga, you have Dvipada Samasaga and Bahupada Samasaga. Is giving next two examples for that. Tataha kumudanathena kamini gandapanduna netranandena chandrena mahendri dik alankrita. Mahendri dik chandrena alankrita. Mahendri dik prachi dik. The eastern direction has been decorated with the moon. Chandrena alankrita. Katham kidrishaha chandraha kumudanathena. He is the lord of lily flowers. Kumudanathaha saha kamini ganda panduna. Kamini naam ganda iva panduhu. Gandasya panduta katham asti tatha pandutvam asyapi asti. Oh, I'm sorry. I think everything is only arthi. There is no shrauti at all here. 1 minute. I thought there was only ellame tritiyadane varudhu solrache. 1 minute. I don't even know where I saw that there is no Shrauti Upama. I can't find it now. Cherry. Okay, there is no Shrauti Upama. Everything else is only Arthi. Yeah, ama. Everything else is only Arthi. The rest is Upama, Dyotaka, Namul. All are only Arthi. Sorry. 1 minute. ततः कुमुदनाथेन कामिनी गण्डपाण्डुना नेत्रानन्देन. सो चन्द्र द मून् इस् द कुमुदनाथ हीस् द लार्ड् आफ् कुमुद लिलि फ्लवर्स् कामिनी गण्डपाण्डु हीस् गण्डम् चीक्स् ही इस् पाण्डु ही इस् वेरि वैट् लैक् द कामिनी गण्ड लैक् द लेडीस् चीक्स्. सो वेन् अ लेडी इस् इन् विरह हर् चीक्स् आर् आल् वेरि वैटिश् इन् पेल् इन् कलर् and tadrishaha pandu pandu tadrisha panduta tadrishi panduta chandre asti. So he is very pale in color. Netra anandam, but he gives great happiness to our eyes. Here there are only two words that are in a samasam. Kamini gandaha eva pandutvam yasya tadrishaha chandraha. Okay, kamini gandaha eva panduhu ngarcha and edathula it sounds like shrauti la. I Okay, I am confused now. ரொம்ப கான்ஃபிடென்ட்டா இருந்து இரு. சமாசகா த்விவிதா த்விபத சமாசகா பகுபத சமாசகா ச இதி உக்தம் தத்ர த்விபத சமாசகா. காமினி காமியமான ஸ்திரீ தஸ்யாஹ கண்டஹ கபோலஹ சைவ பாண்டுஹ பாண்டுவர்ணஹ. சோ காமினி கண்ட இவ காமினி கண்டவத் பாண்டுஹ உபமானானி சாமான்ய வச்சனைஹி உபமான சாதாரண தர்ம வாசக வாசகையோஹோ த்வயோஹோ பதயோஹோ சமாசே. சோ தேர் இஸ் நோ மென்ஷன் ஆஃப் வெதர் இட் இஸ் ஆர்த்தி ஆர் ஷிரௌதி. ஹி ஜஸ்ட் கிவ்ஸ் அஸ் உபமான உபமாத்யோதக லுப்தா அப்படின்னு மாத்திரம் சொல்றார். Okay, I will check and tell you whether it is Arthi, Shrauti or not. In a kid's, I'm not able to say this. Okay, Ratri samaye chandrodaya varnanam idam. Kumudanathena chandrena. Okay, abadi eduthukom. So this is Dvipada Samasaka. You may ask me why it is Dvipadam and why not Bahupadam. Because you have Kamini, Ganda and Pandu. There are three words in this samasam. But that is not the idea here. Kamini, Gandaha is Upamanam. The two words or three words is only for whether it is an Upamana or Upamavachaka or the Sadharmya. Or the Upameyam. Only those two. Whether so in this samasam, Kamini, Ganda, Panduna, you have Upamanam, which is Kamini, Gandaha. That is your Upamanam. And Sadharmyam, which is Panduta, Pandutvam, those two are connected in a samasa. So it is Upamana and Sadharmya are in a samasam. So it is only Dvipada samasam. Kaminyaha Gandaha, Kamini Gandaha, her cheeks. Chandraha Tasya, so Kamini Gandasya Pandutvam Iva Pandutvam, Adava Kamini Gandasya Tulya Panduta, yasya saha. Kamini Gandaha Iva Panduhu Yaha. So it is more like Arthi and not Shrauti. So I think everything is an Arthi Upama, Arthi Luptopama and not Shrauti. I don't remember why there is no Shrauti here. Because the actually if you look at the Samasam, it is only Kamini Ganda Iva Panduhu, which is still straight Yasya Saha. It goes after that only it addresses Chandra. So you can't call it as Shrauti. Keep it at that. Otherwise, just take it as Upama Dyotaka Lukta Dvipada Samasaka. I'll correct it next class. Next is Bahupada Samasaka Upama Dyotaka Lukta Asita Bhujaga Bhishana Asipatraha Ruha Ruhikahita Chitta Turna Charaha Pulakita Tanu Tanuhu Utkapola Kantihi Pratibata Vikrama Darshane Ayam Asit. So I am Raja. Pratibhata Vikrama Darshani, this king, Pratibhata Vikrama, in showing his prowess to the Pratibhata, to the Shatru, enemy army, Tasmin Pratibhata Vikrama Darshani, when he was showing his Vikrama, his bravery among the enemy armies, he was, I am, Asita Bhujaga Bhishana Asipatraha. He had a sword, which was Bhishana, which was very Bhayankaraha, like Asi Bhujaga, Asita Bhujaga, Asita Krishna Bhujagaha, like a Krishna Sarpa, like a black cobra, his Asipatra, his sword was Bhishanam, it was Bhayankara. Ruhi Ruhikahita Chitta Turna Charaha, Turna Charaha, he was roaming very quickly, very fast, and making the chittam ahitam. It was the either he was very agitated, ruhi ruhika. So the meaning is given here is, see, rabhasa utkantha taya ahitam vyaptam yata chittam tena turna charaha. He was agitated in his mind. Ruhi ruhika is rabhasam, that paraparap. Manasla, that is ruhi ruhika. It's the his mind is very agitated, and because of that, Turna Charaha, it is showing in his action. So he's very hyperactive. So he's roaming around in the battlefield very fast. So Rurihika Ahita Chitta Turnacharaha Shigram Charati. Pulakita Tanuhu is very excited to show his shauryam. So Pulakita Tanuhu Romancha Yuktaha Utkapola Kantihi Kapola Kantihi. His cheeks are all shining with Utkatam. Utkatam means Ullasitam. It is shining with the lustre. Very lustrous cheeks he has. That nothing, when you get excited and your there is an adrenaline rush, no, when you're running, your cheeks will be shining and there will be sweat and it will become red for some people. It's like that. So, Utkapola Kantihi Saha Viraha Pratibata Vikrame Darshane Asit. He was like this when he was showing his parakramam in among the enemies. Here, Asita Bhujaga is the Upamanam, standard of comparison, Krishna Sarpaha. Bhishanatvam is the Sadharana Dharmam. Asipatram is Upameyam. All three, Upamana, Upameya, and Sadharana Dharma, are in one samasa itself. Asita Bhujagaha Iva, Bhishanaha, Asipatraha, Yasya Saha. Or Asipatram, Yasya Saha. One who has the Asipatra. So it's a direct comparison between the Asita Bhujaga and the Asipatra. So it is Asita Bhujagena Tulyam. Asita Bhujagena Tulya Bhishana Yuktaha Asipatra. That's how it should be taken as. What was the text before? उपमा द्योतकः इति उपमा प्रतिपादकस्य लोपे षट् समासेन कर्मणः अधिकरणात् च इट डजंट से एनीथिंग ल समासे அவ்வளவுதான் போட்டிருக்காரு ஐ டோன்ட் நோ வாட் ஐ ரெட் அண்ட் ரோட் ஓன்லி வாக்கியகா தத்திதகா ஸ்ரௌதி இஸ் நாட் தேர் விச் மீன்ஸ் திஸ் சமாசகா ஷுட் பி சமாசகா ஸ்ரௌதி இட் சீம்ஸ் மோர் லைக் ஸ்ரௌதி டு மீ சரி சோ அசித புஜக பீஷண அசிபத்ரஹ is your samasta padam, which is samasaga upama dyotaka lupta. That iva is not there, it is lopam inside the samasta padam. Next one, pauram suti yati. Here is where your all the Panini sutrams will come here. Kyang, kyach, and namul. Namul is, I think, later. So we will only look at kyang and kyach today. पौरं सुतीयति जनं समरान्तरेसौ अन्तःपुरीयति विचित्रचरित्रचुञ्चुः नारीयति समरसीम्नि कृपाणपाणेः आलोक्य तस्य चरितानि सपत्नसेना पौरं सुतीयति एव्रिथिङ्ग् इस् टेकन् एस् अ सेपरेट् वर्ड् सो इट् इस् अगेन् द ग्रेट्नेस् आफ् अ किङ्ग् विच् इस् बीङ्ग् डिस्क्रैब्ड् हियर् असौ राजा पौरं सुतीयति. He thinks of his, he acts towards his subjects as he would towards his son. Pauram suti yati, sutam iva acharati iti. Sutam yatha pashyati tatha pauram api pashyati iti pauram suti yati. He acts like that towards his subjects. He thinks of his subjects as his own son. Tatha acharati. So janam samarantare asau antapuri yati pauram janam, I think it should be pauram janam suti yati samarantare asau antap janam antap, sorry, let me look at the text. Pauram janam suti yati. And then you can say janam antapuri yati in rakana. Yeah. Chanchuhu asau samaran. Samarantare antapuri yati. Correct. So vichitra charitra chunchuhu. Chunchuhu is an expert. Kushalaha. He is an expert in showing different characteristics and he's got different characteristics in him. So vichitra charitraha, or he has a very unique personality that. Even in the battlefield, he acts as if he is inside the antapura. Samarantare yuddha bhumau antapure yatha acharati tatha yuddha bhumau acharati. He acts like as if it is his own antapuram. If it is an antapuram or harem where his wife is there, he will be playing around. He will not be in a very serious mode. So just like how he will be very light-hearted in the Antapuram, in the same way he acts like that in the battlefield also. Samarantare, in the battlefield, he acts as if it is like a Antapuram. Samara simni kripanapanehe tasya charitani alokya. When he has a sword in his hand and he just enters the border of the battlefield. Samara simni, not even inside the battlefield. He's not even entered the battlefield. The moment someone sees him at the border, sapatna sena, shatru sena, the moment they see his actions at the border itself, they all act like nari, like a lady. Nari iva sapatna sena acharati. The shatru sena becomes like a lady and very, how to say, they become cowards. They don't want to involve themselves in the battlefield. We are not talking about Jhansi Rani here as an example for Nari. A Nari is someone who does not enter the battlefield. Okay. Let's give some allowance for this poet, Ponapuri. So, Bhauram Janam Sutiyati. Now, each one of the Upama Dyotaka Shabda, the Kyang, Kyach, Kyang and Kyach, both of these pratyayas are actually not Upama Dyotaka. They are added in the sense of Acharanam. It is not Iva. So, Sutam Iva Acharati Iti Sutiyate. That kyach is not added for iva, but it is added for acharati. Sutam yatha acharati. Sutam yatha paripalayati. Sutam yatha sneha chakshusha, sneha mayena chakshusha pasyati. Tatha paurajanam api sneha mayena chakshusha pasyati. Acharanam eva tatra achara acharathe eva. So only instead of that acharanam or acharati, you have sutiyati, that kyach is coming there. Here there can be two types of kyach. One is karma kyach, the other is adhara kyach. Karma means in dvitiya vibhakti, adhara is in saptami vibhakti. So the example for karma kyach is sutiyati. There you have sutaha is your upamanam, upameyam, that which has to be described is your paurajanaha. Pauraha, sadharmyam is sneham, paripalanam, ityadaya, acharaha eva sadharana dharmaha. So that it is only that sadharana dharma which has been made here. It's not the suti yati upama pratipadaka shabdaha is not at all present. Instead of that, he has only used a kyach here, which is sutamiva acharati, upamanad achare iti sutranusaram tatra kyach pratyaha vidhiyate. Okay. And that karma padam is sutam. Sutaha is your prathama bhakti, sutam is your dvitiya bhakti here. The same way, adhara kyach is something instead of the saptami bhakti you have to have. If there is a saptami upapadam, then for that you will have the kyach pratyaya. It is the same sutram, upamana adachare only, the one which is an upamana. But if that upamana is being used in an acharartham, upamanam is sutam, sutaha. Suta is the upamanam. Sutam eva. Sutam iti karma padam upamanam tatra. And after that you say sutam yatha acharati adava eva acharati. That eva is removed. But instead of that eva is not at all featuring in the samasam or in that suti yati, in that karma padam. It is only the acharartham that is present in the suti yati. In antapuri yati, in nari yati. All these three words only have the achararartha. They do not have the upama pratipadaka shabdaha. Okay? That's why I have written upama pratipadaka sthane. Instead of that, you have achararartha. But it is not conveying the meaning of eva. Keep that in mind. That is why it is upama dyotaka lupta. Sariya? So, adharakyachi upama dyotaka lupta upamanam. Here you will have antapuram. Antapure yatha acharati, tatha samarantare api acharati. In the antapura, in samara, which is your adhara, which is the saptami bhakti. Okay? So antapura, samarantaram is your upameyam. Sadharmyam is swachandagamanam or kridanam. Swachandagamanam means you can go however he wants. Nobody is going to obstruct him. Whereas in the samaram, generally people are going to stop you from moving forward. But he, there is nobody to stop him. Ko api vignam na karoti. So he can easily go in front and conquer all the enemies. So yatha antapure yatha acharati swachandam chalati athava kridati, that acharartha can give you so many meanings there. So antapuri yati, that is left to the sahrdaya. Okay, next is kyang. In that is kyang, where the kyang should be is kartuhu kyang salopaha. So you had karma and adhara. For karma you will have kyach pratyaya, for adhara you will have kyach pratyaya. If it is a karta, if it is a direct comparison, if it is not the comparison of an action or how he does, here it is a direct connection where sapatna sena nari iva acharati. That nari padam is in the first vibhakti, so it is a karta. Nari iva acharati. Nari yatha kartaryam pradarshayati, tatha sapatna sena, shatru sena api kartaryam pradarshayati. Kartaryam is cowardice. It's being like a coward, or it just runs away. Palayati. Yatha nari palayati yuddha bhuma, yuddha bhumehe, tatha. You can take it like that. So here, kartuhu kyang salopascha, that is your sutram which gives the kyang pratyaya after the kartrupada upamana. Okay, so nariyati. We'll stop with this. I think that's all I prepared. Illa adutathum pannite. Okay, namul is there. Okay, so we'll do this also, then the Luptopama one portion will be over, where only one is not present. The next he will address where two are not present and then three are not present. Okay, so Upama Dyotaka Lupta, for Namul you have both Karmani and Kartari Upapade, Namul Pratyaha Upama Dyotaka. Mridhe Nidaga Garmamshu Darsham Pashyanti Tampare Sapunaha Partha Sancharam Sancharati Avanipatihi. It's a very peculiar pratyaya that is used here, which is namul. When there is a karma, when something is in dvitiya vibhakti, you will have, so okay, let me explain the shlokam and then go. So saha, again it is about an avanipatihi, a king who is being described here. Pare shatravaha, other enemies, tam pashyanti, they look at this king. Tam is again in Dvitiya Vibhakti here. So the Dvitiya Vibhakti person is being compared here. And the Upamanam is also going to be in Dvitiya Vibhakti now. Tam sarve pashyanti, pare pashyanti, shatravaha pashyanti, mridhe, mridhe, yuddhe. Yuddhe tam evam pashyanti. Katham pashyanti? Nidagha gharmamshum yatha pashyanti, tatha etam api rajanam pashyanti. Nidagha, nidagha, summer. Garmamshu is a sun. Garmamshu, one who has hot rays. Garma amshu yasya saha, garmamshu suryaha. Nidagha rutau, grishma rutau suryaha yatha bhayankaraha asti. It is very difficult to look at him at all. You cannot directly open your eyes and look at a summer sun itself. It is very difficult to look at him. Now if it is a summer sun, he is resplendent and it is a midday sun, very difficult to look at him. In the same way, eshaha raja api, very difficult to look at him because satadrisha tejo yuktaha asti. He has got such a kanti and he acts in such a manner during the battlefield. So very tough to face him. More than look at him, it is tough to face him. So nidaga garmamshu darsham tam, it is an adjective to tam rajanam. Nidagha garmamshum iva shatravaha tam pashyanti. So that is how the samasam happens here. It is actually that darsham, the idea of namul pratyaya is upamane karmani cha, upamane, when the upamanam is in karma. Nidagha garmamshum yatha pashyanti tatha. And what you do is that upamana vachaka shabda, which is your karma, that is the upapadam. That is the upapadam, means it is this padam that is next to the kriyapadam. Kriyapadam is Pashyanti here. Don't look at the shloka. Okay. Please look at this line here. I am talking about this portion here. So it is only that samasam, nidaga garmamshu darsham, how that samasa forms is nidaga garmamshum iva pashyanti. Pashyanti is your kriyapadam, which has the upapada. Upapada is the word next to it, which is your nidaga garmamshu, that is in karma, and that is the upamanam. When such a case happens, instead of Pashya dhatu, that will become, that the drishya pashya dhatu will get namul pratyaya. Drishya dhato ho paschat namul pratyaya vidhiyate. And then how is that form happening? It becomes an adjective to tam. Nidaga garmamshu darsham tam. One who resembles a nidaga garmamshu, as if they look at him like that. You will have to use the same dhatu to end the sentence also. So mrude yuddhe tam rajanam pare shatravaha nidaga garmamshu darsham pashyanti. They look at him like how they will look at a samarsa. That upama pratipadaka lopaha is there. Instead of that upama pratipadakam, we have namul pratyaya, which also gives us the idea that someone is being compared and it is in karma. Next is kartari. Kartari upapade namul pratyayaha. It is in the second line. What is the meaning of the second line? Sapunaha, that king, that saha avanipatihi, that king, punaha, he roams around, sancharati, partha sancharam, like how Arjuna will roam around. Parthaha yatha sancharati, tatha eshaha sancharati. That is the parthaha yatha. It is again in karta. It is the first case. So, upamane karmani changardhu, karma da irukka andha sutratla. There should be another sutram to show the kartuhu kyanga salopaha. 1 minute. Parthaha. Upamane karmani cha itri sutrena cha anukrishte upama vachake kartari upapade sati sampurvaka dhatoho. Okay. Dhatoho namul. So that cha indicates that there is a karta that where edo or sutratlende it is being anuvritti there. I don't know which sutram is anuvritti here, which should have that kartari padam, kartripadam, which has been taken for this sutram also by saying namul upamane karmani cha, which means kartari also exists. Kartari upapade, what is that? Parthaha iva. Partha is the kartripadam for this samasa. Partha is the kartripadam, which is the upapadam, which is present beside sancharati. So you form the samasa partha sancharam by adding namul pratyaya to charidhatu, and the word becomes partha sancharam, similar to the actions of partha. Okay, so this is your upama dyotakam with namul pratyayam. With this section is over, where upama dyotaka lupta of all your samasaga, karma kyach, adhara kyach, kyang, karmani upapade namul, and kartari upapade namul. All of these six varieties are done. Okay? We take it as six because samasaga is just one variety. The next is how, when two are absent or three are absent. Etat dvilope quip. We'll go with that during the next class. We'll have it tomorrow. Okay?